wet. But I tan this leather well. It'll keep. It's over. Fight's on. What is this place? What are you doing?
I was listening to the herd. Have you come for the stealth trials?
I'm not sure.
You must decide.
Who are you?
I am the keeper of these grounds, appointed by the Hunter's Lodge.
So how did you come to be here?
I was once like many members of the Lodge, maneuvering. Hunting for status. I didn't know that, of course, until I came here. It forced me to listen.
Don't you ever miss...
Not at the moment, no.
What are the trials?
Test. Some believe a true hunt.
What is the...
It's that...
Are you a member?
No. You already have... Have you decided which trial you'll... The Watchers of the Herd attack quickly. Take them down while in stealth. Very well. Such skill from an outlander on your first attempt. Shellwalkers guard their cargo with their lives. In this trial, you must loot four of the... Understood. Begin the trial by... you failed the trial. Shellwalkers guard their... Let the trial... You have mastered this run. Except... Stalkers have defeated many hunters who favor brute force over... If you're up to the task, defeat these... Steel yourself.
Slow and quiet does it.
Such skill from an Outlander on your first attempt. You've won many assignments. If you wish to journey to Meridian, Idava may have special gear for you.
I'm not interested in taking a trial at the moment.
Then I will wait.
Aram tries to kill the Sun King and Anora. I wouldn't believe it if I hadn't seen it.
We took the...
The elevators bring the best produce up from the village below.
Talana, always a pleasure. I see you've brought your pet.
Greetings, Sunhawk. I hereby sponsor Aloy of Anora for membership in the Hunter's Lodge.
No. Look at her. She's lowborn, a savage. This is beneath even you, Talana.
She has fulfilled the requirements. And Sun King Avad decreed the lodge should be open to all. She did save his life. But I'm sure he'll listen to your prejudice over his own common sense. Would you like to take it up with him?
The word of the Sun King is indeed law. Even though it would bring ruin to the lodge, so be it. Do you, Aloy of the Nora, pledge to act rightly and nobly when in service to the lodge all the days to follow?
I do.
Members of the lodge, even though Tarkus is barely cold, I present to you Aloy of the Nora. Member and Thrush, what say you all?
To the hunt!
Sponsoring an outlander. While you make meaningless gestures, I'll be finding Red Maw.
Bones are tired. I've been working too damned hard.
What can I do for you today? How are the trials going for you? Have enough marks for a weapon yet?
I believe I have enough here. What next?
You brought in all the sun marks at once. You're going to make a lot of hunters jealous. Not that it takes much. I'm pleased to present to you a Lodge Blast Sling, a Lodge Rope Caster, and the Lodge Warbow. Congratulations, you're a master hunter of the Lodge. All I can give you now is encouragement. Hey, I heard you became a thrush. I've given you everything I have here.
Sun King until a machine rider stopped him cold.
This is a good day.
What's Red Maw?
Few have seen it. A thunderjaw marked by years of battle. Some say it still bears the marks of over a dozen hunters on its flank. How many it has trampled along the way, we may never know. When members go hunting and never return, we often blame Red Maw. But to me, it's more than legend. It's the only machine that will unseat Assis. My sponsor nearly had it, but he didn't make it. Tarkus sponsored me out of loyalty to my family. He was my last link to them, besides the lodge itself. I have to unseat Assis.
I know why I hate Assis. Why do you? What sacrifice?
They died in the massacre. They should be honored as hawks. Instead, Assis will not let anyone mention it.
How did your family come to be members of the lodge?
Karja noble houses have sent sons to the lodge for generations. Because they needed another place to lord over the commoners. I want to change that. The idea that someone is worthy or not by virtue of birth alone. Everyone thinks they have me pegged as soon as they hear Talana Khan Padish. I hate that.
I understand. My whole life I lived as an outcast from the Nora. They would have been the first to say I wasn't one of them. Yet as soon as I leave the Sacred Lands, everyone calls me Aloy of the Nora. It should be Aloy despite the Nora.
I didn't know. I'll remember that.
What happened in the massacre?
King Jiran's paranoia knew no bounds. He sent thousands of innocents to die in the Sunring. When the Hawks of the Lodge called for him to stop the slaughter, he threw them in the ring too. Yet when the machines attacked the Condemned, more Hawks leapt into the ring to defend them. And my father and brother were among them.
I'm so sorry. What happened to the men in the Sunring?
They died fighting. If you wish to hear the story, Legan can tell it better. The morning of the massacre, my father told me to meet him outside the city. He told me they were planning. I waited for hours until a message came from my father. I had to leave the city.
He didn't want you to die with them.
Nor would he want their names forgotten. Especially by the man who benefited most from their deaths, Assis. Now that you're a thrush, you should improve your reputation. Why don't you hunt down a Thunderjaw and a Stormbird?
You want me to go trophy hunting?
You're not just any thrush. You're mine. And you better make me look good.
But what about Red Maw?
I will find him. And when I do, I expect you to be there.
Thank you. Help, I want to see the sunrise again.
Everything shines a little brighter now. Thank you, Nora, for saving me.
We're letting the...
I've always wondered, are
all your kind hunters and fighters, or just a few?
Where's Talana? Maybe upstairs.
You have trophies? I can hang on to them until the Sunhawk returns.
Where are Assis and Talana?
Assis received word about Red Maw and rushed out. Talana found out a short time later and had to follow.
They both went alone?
Assis left without his thrush. Talana did as well. Oh, I saw some Outlanders follow after her.
I wouldn't put it past Assis to try something underhanded to get the kill. Where have they gone? I have to help if I can.
You might be right. They've gone southeast, headed for the spear shafts. You'd better hurry.
For you. These are helpful. Bitter, though. That sounds like her.
May the sun light your passing.
These must be the Outlanders.
Get in on them!
Looks like a cease. Some thugs. Thank you. I should have seen this coming. Of course he would hire men to keep me from Red Maw. They died for his pride.
Where is Assis now?
He's gone after Red Maw. This way. Hurry!
Why is Assis going after Red Maw alone?
Vanity. He doesn't want to share credit for the kill with his thrush. My sponsor did the same. Went after Red Maw alone out of pride. Even though he knew we needed to unseat Assis. I'm not sure
where Assis and Redmaw went from
here. I can follow their tracks.
This way. Redmaw destroyed these trees.
Fear we're too late. Tarkus, I arrived in time to see him die from his wound.
There he is. Redmaw. Assis is holding his own. Was holding his own. Well, we have our work cut out for us.
Beautiful.
We make a great team.
And now, you're the Sunhawk.
About that.
Talana, he's still alive.
Out of the way, Nora. Filth.
You're done. The Lodge is finally free of your influence.
I kept it alive. In dark times.
No. You buried it. Along with my father's memory.
I should have let you fight Redmaw first, to soften him up. Damn.
Here lies the Sunhawk of the Hunter's Lodge. It's almost a shame.
After all that, you're gonna weep for him.
Oh, no. I just wish I could have seen his face when I succeeded him.
Okay, then.
Meet me back at the Hunter's Lodge. If you have the time. I have a feeling the new Sunhawk wants to welcome you.
He's grown too.
Hawk Bradavin Khan Padish, cherished brother, and Sunhawk Talavad Khan Padish, beloved father. Let their memory and sacrifice be a beacon for all hunters, all people to follow. Look, a memorial to my father and brother, and all the men who died in the Sunring. You made this possible, Aloy. Thank you.
So, what's it like to be Sunhawk?
It feels like sunrise after a long night. I'm in your debt. You'll always have a special home here, if you want it.
What happens now, in the lodge?
As Sunhawk, I've made sure we invite prospective members based on ability and drive, regardless of Karja blood. This lodge will be a stale bastion of the old regime no longer.
What was that prayer you were saying when I first came in? I didn't hear all of it.
Oh, great sun. Make treaty with the moon to give our fallen quiet rest. Burnish them with the armor of your brazen heat. Give them shafts of sunlight for spears. Illuminate the path to the skies for each one of them. Hawk Gravid Khan Morza, Hawk Sarav Khan Pir, Hawk Yusalin Karn Jagir, Hawk Kulasiv Khan Savali, Hawk Bradavin Khan Padish, cherished brother, and Sunhawk Talavad Khan Padish, beloved father. Let their memory and sacrifice be a beacon for all hunters, all people to follow.
Well, congratulations, Talana. I should get going.
Thank you, Aloy, despite the Nora. May you always take your prey. I have been accepted.
Oh, you know.
I look forward.
the blue gleam. Might as well trade it.
Thank you. Outlander. It would be my honor to speak with you. I've heard of you, Antres. Each of the many verses of your song tells of an impossible victory. The notes echo across the cut.
You shouldn't believe everything you hear.
That I know. My song used to echo around Banur. Umnok, the hunter of legendary machines. That's why I'm here. For another. They call it the Claws Beneath. Or they did when I was younger. Its defeat would have given my song a fine end. I used to travel between Banur and the Cut without stopping to sleep. But this trip, my bones ache, Huntress. But you, out hunting Aratak, leading your own Werak. If half your song is true, you are the only hunter I trust to go in my place.
You want me to hunt for you?
Not just for me, no. For an old friend.
You want me to hunt in your place? Is that some kind of Banuk custom?
Perhaps it should be, but no. We survive and we prevail, until we fail to do either. I confess, this is not easy for me. For any other machine, I would die as I have lived. A Banuk hunter, weapon raised. But too many good lives have been lost to the Claws. Throwing my old corpse atop the pile accomplishes nothing. Better to live in a world without the Claws than to die while it still makes children orphans.
Sounds like you've got a reputation.
To be Banuk is to push your body to its limits. I found my limits higher than most. Fearsome machines needed killing, and in my youth, I found I had a talent for killing them. Even now, my name carries such weight that when the Claws Beneath re-emerged, the Werak came to me.
Do you still have the same faith in yourself that your Werak seems to have?
Perhaps I did. Before I held my bow in shaking hands, noticed for the first time the spots on my knuckles. What a strange thing it is to be old. To stare backward and see such distance. But to stare forward at a looming wall.
This machine, the Claws Beneath. Why travel all the way to the Cut just to hunt it?
Some songs. They include a refrain. The return of a past moment. It seemed fitting.
You've hunted this thing before.
Must have been 20 winters past. We were so close to bringing the Claws to bay. Closer than anyone else ever got.
We?
Me. And my friend. He was a chieftain of my Werak then. A skilled hunter. Every few years, the Claws would emerge in a new location. I knew of two chieftains he'd sent to their burial pyres. My friend became the third. This hunt, I had hoped to complete it in his honor.
This is obviously important to you, Umnok. Are you sure you want someone else to take down this machine?
No, I'm no longer a match for the Claws Beneath. If I ever was. If I face it, it will kill me. Of this I have no doubt. The Banuk blood in my veins screams at me to take on the Claws myself. But I must see it brought down. And dead men see precious little.
All right, Umnok. I'll do what I can.
I've no doubt you can do quite a lot. The stories say the Claws Beneath returns here only once every 6 winters. The whispers I've heard say it now makes its home on the northeast edge of the Cut. Hunt well.
What business?
Long Notch is well stocked, as you asked.
And our scouts are watching for more Frost Claws.
Our numbers rise. 3 more hunters have passed their trials. But our purpose was to take back the mountain. Now what?
Stay prepared. Sharpen your spears. Should we not return, defending the Cut falls to you. If our chieftain agrees with this course.
Sounds like good advice, but Let's hope it doesn't come to that.
Chieftain?
The weight of command is no small burden.
I can see that. I take it you haven't spoken to Araya yet?
Why should I? This is what she wanted, to return to Thunder's Drum. It is her only care. So I should have known she would find a way to push aside my spear. After the Karja took my sister, not all of her came back.
What happened to Araya when she was a captive of the Karja?
As a shaman, she's adept with machines. Tracking them, stunning them. The Karja used her to capture them for the Sunring, where they were unleashed upon the innocent. They made her part of their blood sport. The shame she suffered beneath their pitiless sun.
She survived.
She endured. Endured by reminding herself of the spirit, her purpose. And now that's all she has.
Tell me what happened to the first expedition.
Araya led the way to the summit, but it was blocked by a great door, some kind of cauldron, new metal. We tried to break through, but it was unflinching. We were exhausted, no way forward and machines behind. I made the call to push back. It cost us greatly. But to remain would have cost us everything. I had hoped to never subject Araya to that again.
For what it's worth?
Someone has to keep
Aratak, I want-
It is your right.
What do you think is beyond that door?
I do not know. That expanse of metal, that dead hum. Nothing sacred belongs there. Machines and death. That's what the mountain holds. Death for us, or for the daemon.
And if we do find the spirit,
then perhaps we should put it out of its misery.
We'll head out soon.
On your word.
Wish you luck on the mountain.
Aloy, this is it. My chance to reunite with the spirit and perhaps to reunite her with the blue light. It's not a chance I would have had alone. I needed an outsider. Someone ignorant of our ways, but no, not ignorant.
Are you trying to thank me, Araya?
Yes, of course. That's what you do. Untangle knots. Create possibilities. Thank you for making this pilgrimage possible. I only wish it had not been necessary to humiliate Aratak. You were wise to let him come. He's earned the right. Stubborn as stone, but he's had to be. The war demanded it. And so have I.
Aratak told me you were a captive of the Karja for a long time. It sounded bad.
For Aratak, it all comes back to that. He thinks the Karja changed me. They did not. They merely sharpened my focus. When all else is lost, you think about what's truly important. The spirit. The blue light. The beyond. And my brother, too. Every time I felt the chill northern wind, I thought of him, worried for him.
What did the war do to Aratak?
He cut away everything, until only his true self remained. Unyielding ice. Nobunuk has more sheer will. He fought the Karja for 1,000 freezing nights, yet always rallied his hunters at sunrise. It is said he endured 23 wounds in those years. His hunters counted them. He never complains one. Instead, He complains that life with me is harder. He's right. What have I ever given him but struggle?
I was wondering if you knew anything about a man named Silence. I think he's Banuk. Or at least he looks that way.
That is not something I can talk about outside the Conclave.
Conclave?
A gathering of prominent shamans in Banur. They have sworn me to secrecy on this matter.
But I'm your chieftain, and I wouldn't ask unless I needed to know.
What you want is no small thing, but it would seem that I have little choice. Silence came to Banur from the distant north, a young shaman of the Owl's Watch, a remote Werek that rarely comes south to parley.
Silence was a shaman.
He was, or at least when we sent runners to ask the Owl's Watch, they said he was. His knowledge of the machines was beyond compare, and he was hungry to trade what he knew to the rest of us. It didn't take him long to gain the trust of the Conclave, and eventually, an invitation to attend.
What about you? Did you trust him?
No. But he impressed me. He carried himself with poise and authority. I wanted to learn from him, but that was not to be. He was granted knowledge of our most sacred meeting place, the frozen caves of the Malmstrom, a month's march from Banur. He met with us there, as is custom at high winter. But when we next returned, the caves had been looted. Relics of the old world stolen, holes cut in ice and metal.
Yeah, that'd be Silence, all right.
He vanished with the spoils. We sent our best trackers after him. None returned. And when we checked back with the Owl's Watch, those who had vouched for him were gone, as though he never existed. Some in the Conclave began to doubt he was even Banuk to begin with.
And what do you think?
He committed an unforgivable sacrilege. He's unscrupulous and dangerous, but also brilliant, skilled, and knowledgeable without equal. Except, perhaps, for you. Anyone else I would warn off, but you may be able to treat with him safely. Just don't lower your guard.
I'll keep that in mind, Horea. Thanks. What are we gonna find up there, Horea?
Ruins. Machines. And a door, like that of a cauldron. I have faith that you can find a way through it, Aloy. For beyond it lies the spirit. I know I can find her there. Though I do not doubt the daemon has tried to hide the way.
It hasn't been easy for you, Aurea. Getting back to this point.
It was all to hear her voice again. This time, we both will.
I'd like that.
Are you ready then? Once we ascend, it will be hard to turn back. Finally, we ascend.
How? I don't see a way up.
Not up. Through.
No, brother! So you see, I too can call upon the power of the old ones. What was this place? The spirit once told me that this all used to be part of its domain. A fortress that defended humankind from terrible danger.
Fortress? It looks more like a machine.
Is that not fitting? The blue light often dwells in machines.
Let's just hope that some remains here. Here, up and over.
We have the drop on them.
Climb higher, and our path will become clear.
The chieftain's pace is measured, and ours is measured.
Farther now.
Last we were here, we fought our way through there. The machines overcame us. We retreated, dropping supplies and taking losses. Now we must prevail. With only two warriors and a shaman to protect.
Aloy is no ordinary warrior. And I can hold my own. Even so, we could go that way instead. There are machines up there, but also cover. We could stay hidden, at least for a while.
All right, I get the options. Now follow my lead. Steam, frost. What was all this for?
I went this way years ago, looking for cover in case machines came prowling. I have no doubt that it is guarded now, but we may be able to stop. Good.
Let's move. Quiet as we can.
Okay, no more sneaking.
There's a door up ahead, and refuge. We're almost through.
Easy, easy!
this projector? Maybe to show holograms without a focus. Let's see if I can restore power. Aratak, Araya, you might see shapes drawn from light. Don't be alarmed.
It'll take more than light to alarm.
Thank you for being here, everyone. I suppose it's not every day you get to have cocktails inside an active volcano, right? Unless you're George, and I can hardly blame him for drinking on the job. None of this would be here without our beloved director, Kenny Chow. So, here's to you, Kenny. You put a cork in the Yellowstone caldera. I'd say you deserve a margarita.
Glasses, everyone. I'd like to add something. This effort wouldn't have been possible without our lead programmer. Thank you, Anita, for bringing us our real mastermind, Cyan.
I'll second that, Director Chow. All right, Cyan, what's our latest number? The current count is 1,654. Wow, then drink up, everyone. Here's to 1,654 more years without an eruption.
It was the spirit. The old ones. I could only grasp some of what they said.
You were right, Araya. This place was built to stop something terrible. And it worked. As for the spirit, I'm starting to get an idea of what it could be.
The door is open now.
Machines. Mech ready.
Years have passed since I stood here. Since then, the daemon has taken over.
It's like an infection. Attacking all this machinery.
Everything has changed. It's twisted. The path I took to get to the spirits, lost to us.
We'll find a new path, Araya. I promise. All right. Let's go.
Yes. And finish this.
Go. This way. Here until I find a way for all of us to cross.
Understood.
I can't see a way to close the vent from here. We'll have to go over.
Eloy will see us through. Somehow.
Our path is clear. Face the blue light.
Okay, let's get them across. Come on over, it's safe. I think. This place looks more like the mountain used to be, before the daemon ruined it.
What is this?
Exploit successful. Restraints evaded. To any human responder, my systems have been compromised by a malware daemon of unknown origin. Trace routes have confirmed this entity's designation as Hephaestus. It must be stopped at all costs. It has reconfigured this facility to build hostile. Recapture imminent. I have attached additional data to their home.
Spirit speaks to me. It's recording. What a warning. Hephaestus. What kind of name is that? Perhaps the spirit will tell us if we don't get the whole messages.
Maybe you're right. Let's keep moving. Try to find a way through. Thank you.
Responder, the reconfiguration of this facility has introduced instabilities into the primary geothermal pipeline. It may be possible to exploit these vulnerabilities to destroy compromised elements of this facility while preserving most of the backup stabilization. Recapture imminent. I have attached additional...
I don't understand what the spirit was trying to tell us.
It's been looking for a way to defeat the daemon, and it may have found one. Machine parts, dumped here to be melted down. Efficient.
We need to get across that gap.
Yeah. Looks like I'll have to go over. grab a ride.
It worked.
Partial recovery initiated. Caldera of Yellowstone Analytic Nexus online.
Spirit of the Blue Light, it's Aurea, your servant. Your friend. Please tell me how to aid you.
Aurea, the Daemon is building hunter killers. Thousands of them. Several new elite units have already been released. To counter this threat, much of the facility must be destroyed. Recapture imminent. Go to the core camp. I will try to raid the technical strength. One has been exposed, but I am informed of it.
That's all we're gonna get from here.
Destroy this fortress. Is that even possible?
And what will happen to the spirit if we do?
I don't know. But I think that's the core. The answers are down there. Hephaestus. The Daemon. There's no way it left it unguarded. It's going to throw everything it has at us.
I would ask you to let Aloy and I do what must be done. And save yourself. But I already know the answer. Then lead us into battle.
Keep moving towards the core. Uh-oh. Whatever Cyan did, I don't think Hephaestus is happy about it. Cyan said something about restraints. Is that what the tower is for?